look what we have here!
Stalker 2 sold over 1 million copies in only a few days. Not only did it break a narrative, it must have been
an anomaly.
Thank you. Thank you. No, I'll be here all week. I'll be here all week. Try the fish. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, let's go, baby. Once again,
welcome back to the channel. This is now my 5th time recording this video. No, I'm serious. It's going to be a lot of fun.
I'm going insane.
But besides all the insanity happening on my end, being unable to actually press the record button multiple times in OBS, it looks like apparently Stalker 2 has now sold over 1 million copies in only a few days' time. I guess that entire narrative of Game Pass cannibalizing sales pretty much just got left on its face. But you know what happens? I'll tell you what happens, but let's get into it though, shall we? Wario64 tweeted out, Stalker 2 Heart of Chernobyl has sold over 1 million copies. 1 million copies were sold, and many more Stalkers joined the artifact hunt with Game Pass. Well, isn't that interesting, my friends? It looks like Game Pass subscribers went up because more people were actually playing Stalker 2 on Game Pass. On top of that, they sold over 1 million copies in only a few days. I guess the narrative has been debunked, my boy. Yeah, Even without needing a PlayStation for sales, the game has sold over 1 million copies. Not only that, being a 73 on Metacritic, didn't really hurt the game at all, because anybody who's played Stalker since 2007 obviously knows that this game is basically exactly like, you know, the first ones. Just buggy as all hell, but goddamn, they're immersive. The thing is, though, the copium doesn't end there, because apparently the Metacritic score wasn't high enough, even though we all know journalists don't know how to play video games, because this game isn't holding your hand every time all the way through. And because the sales were over 1 million copies, apparently, it's still not enough for PlayStation fanboys. Oh, yes! Yes! It happens every time! Look, here's the thing. We're going to go over some salt, and then on top of that, we're going to give you guys a very delicious, a very amazing, a very fun... This is how you don't play Stalker 2. Trust me, you're going to want to have a seat for this one. I guarantee it. YMNISV1 says, this is nuts when you consider how downgraded and broken the game is. But then again, the platform it's available on don't have standards.
Wait.
This clown is not really going to sit here and talk about a platform not having standards when he's the same who was capping for Concord. Remember that? You were that guy, my boy. That was you. You were the one sitting there capping, saying, oh, Concord is so great. I love how good Concord is. Yet at the same time, the game was so bad and so critically panned, Sony actually had to lose money. They had to refund the game. They shut the servers down. It wasn't even coming back as free to play. That's how bad this game is. And you have the gall, the audacity, the testicular fortitude to say that Xbox, another platform, which obviously you just really don't care about apparently, says that they don't have any standards because simply a game is released buggy from a company that was literally in a war zone. But hey, no, let's not get in the way of this, my guy. No, because apparently you are the same clown who sits there and does everything they possibly can to defend and bootlick a corporation. I bet you if they step in dog, you'd be the first one behind Herman Hulst grabbing his ankles, licking it up nice and clean. Push Square literally made this article, and here was the headline. You ready? Stalker 2's technical troubles likely fixed by the time it comes to PS5. Nobody tell them. I wondered what happened with Xbox Got No Games. Remember that? Remember Xbox Has No Games? Now PlayStation fanboys want every game from Xbox on their PlayStation. What happened to the narrative, my boy? Literally, PS5 has no games. If it wasn't for Xbox, y'all would still be playing Concord. Oh wait, you can't. They took that bish away. All you guys had this year was fucking Astrobot. All right, you had Stellar Blade money had it. You had Final Fantasy VII Rebirth money had it. You had Rise of the Ronin, which honestly was just a... I don't know why you guys even tried to cap for that game. And then, bro, it's just, oh my God. And, oh, but we had Helldivers 2. Helldivers 2 is being carried by PC. Let's be honest, okay? No, let's be honest. The fact that you're sitting there not even knowing why Stalker 2 has technical performance problems is honestly hilarious. This is GSC, the same company that is in literal war right now. The same development studio that actually lost developers due to the war. The same studio that from since 2007 has had the buggiest games of all time. And you think they're gonna get fixed by the time it gets to PS5? You think your PS5 Pro is gonna be able to fix this game? Run it any better than the 864p it's running at right now on consoles? You think so? You guys have the same Zen 2 3600 CPU on the same console that the Xbox Series X has. Y'all don't know nothing about hardware, and it's honestly insane to me. The fact that you literally wrote this article and 383 people were like, "Yup, that's the one for me. Can't wait." Same as it ever was. Same as it ever was. Japan hates Xbox replies to Destin saying, "It's garbage, dustbin. More low-rated broken buggy crap for the welfare pass. Xbox will never have good games. LMAO." Japan hates Xbox and PC. Now, he had to add the "and PC" to that, trust me. The fact that Square Enix is putting all their games on Xbox now. So clearly they don't hate Xbox in Japan. The fact that Capcom said that the majority of their sales came from PC. Clearly they don't hate PC, because these are two Japanese studios literally doing the thing that you don't think they should do, yet being successful by doing it. Oh, you gotta love it. On top of that, can we pick a different insult for Destin? Dustbin isn't even good. Like, it's not even a good insult. You can't even figure it out right. You probably stole it from somebody else. All right, get better at what you're doing, my boy. And let's talk about this whole welfare pass thing. I have never in my life seen a hobby where people are gloating at others for spending more money and calling other players broke or hobby enjoyists broke for not spending as much money as they do. Imagine gloating that you are a pay pig for a corporation that doesn't even know you exist. And here you are. "I'll never have good games. It's for people on welfare." Huh? Bro, what are you talking about? Imagine gloating that you're spending more money. People spending less money are getting more video games than you do, and they have to spend less. I bet you, you're the same kind of guy who lives in a shack or in a van down by the river, and you're the one plugging in your PS5 into a goddamn CRT that you had to steal from the actual garbage dump to play your games, because honestly, everybody, "I spend all my money on Sony, they get all my money," and you are literally broke in Japan. You know what probably is happening, though? You're giving all your money to all the girls that are siphoning you away in the OnlyFans in Japan. That's what you're doing. I bet you they're like, "Oh, my little white gaijin, you're so precious and cute," as they run their fingers through your greasy encrusted hair, and you're unable to be like, "Oh, finally, a woman's touch." The fact you still have to pay for it is honestly absurd. Imagine shitting on other people for having to spend less money while you sit there and you gloat at other people for spending more money. And when it comes to PS5, I can't wait for you to flip that script, my boy. Every time. PlayStation Yes Sir says low ass sales, and then he shows the actual player counts for Stalker 2 and Flight Simulator 2024. Can we stop with this right now? I'm done with this. I'm so sick of people using player counts on Steam to either console war or grift on the other side. I just player counts do not mean sales, and sales do not mean player counts. It doesn't matter. People can buy the game and literally not play it until months later. They may just want the game in their library. It happens all the time, and we see it happen over and over again. PlayStation fanboys, "Look at the player counts. We got more players, therefore there's more sales." That's not how that works. That's not how any of that works. And you're sitting there using these player counts while at the same time, Helldivers 2 is literally dominating because of PC. The fact that nobody bought LEGO Horizons. What happened to that player count, my boy? The fact that Concord again failed because nobody played that game. But look, hey, look, you can sit here and try to talk about sales and then using player counts for it, even though they don't make any fucking sense. But then again, you are the same clown that has done nothing but sit and suckle off a corporation all the time. But it's gonna get better, I promise, ladies and gentlemen. It gets better. Nico Mueller tweeted out, "Haters, Game Pass destroys sales, reality." And then he posts the top sellers on Steam, with Stalker 2 being the number 2 selling game. That Joe Kersol quote tweets Nico's tweet and says, "Player count aren't sales." Joe, You have to be
Rockin' Issue.
I'm sorry. The PlayStation fan base truly is the most
Rockin' Issue
people I've ever met in my life. On one hand, you got a clown using player counts saying they're not sales. On the other hand, you got a guy saying that top sellers, which are the sales of a game, is player count, but then that's not sales. What is even happening here? How does this even... No Child Left Behind is literally happening right in front of our eyes. How is this even a thing, a concept, a thought, a process? Player counts aren't sales. And then he quote tweets the top sale. Ah! All of you clowns are
Rockin' Issue!
Stop doing this! Stop being like this! You wonder, why did he always pick on us? It happened every time. He never picked on it. Because you do shit like this! This is you! The people that you watch are this koala on one hand, and the other ones literally do the most horrible shit on Twitter, and you wonder why, like, how come it's always us? It's never the Xbox guy, because they learned their lesson! They learned their lesson 6 years ago from me! They picked their up and said, you know what, we're not gonna, listen, we got pushed in already too many times, we're not doing this. I'm not saying the Xbox One X is gonna be a 1080 Ti, I'm not saying that. They learned that lesson! You clowns still haven't learned that lesson, apparently. Oh, and here comes the piece de resistance, ladies and gentlemen. That's right, our boy, our pal, our friend, our confidanta, Reforged Gaming decided to stream Stalker 2. Our little DSP of the community is now once again trying his hand at actually playing a video game that doesn't hold his hand. Let's take a look and see how it goes, because this is how you don't play Stalker 2.
How do I get back into my inventory? Oh, down on the D-pad. Okay. Equip that. Ow. Well. I don't understand what's happening. I'm just trying to get this stuff, man. I don't understand. That seems like an area where you would kind of like learn how to loot and equip your stuff. And there's a spark monster that I'm supposed to run from.
Oh, yes, my boy. How do you do this to yourself every single time? First of all, you saw the anomaly pass through the area. That was number one. When you literally walked in, you saw the anomaly end the very existence of two stalkers in that zone. Then you can't figure out how to loot in the actual game, which honestly, I mean, you can just, okay, how do you open your inventory? That was something I wouldn't expect somebody to say in a video game, but still, let's continue. You then don't even use loot all. You loot one item at a time. And then as you walk forward, you see the anomaly again pass through you, realizing, oh, that is a dangerous thing. It's literally lightning. You walk on the right-hand side, which shows, hey, this is a safe spot because I saw the anomaly pass through me and I took zero damage. You then, like a dog trying to go after a bone, go after the NPC on the floor trying to loot them. You get directly hit in the exact spot where that enemy was intended taken out, and you're like, oh, I should heal myself. You then heal, you don't move out of the way, you try to loot again as you see the anomaly pass through you again, and then you die. You are literally DSP, bro. You are literally DSP, and you're like, how is this a place where you supposed to learn how to loot? You're not supposed to learn how to loot there. You've learned how to loot 10 minutes beforehand in the game. That's not a new thing to you. The concept here is, oh, there are dangers in this area, and there are spots where I can be safe. How do you not get this? How does simple explanations of like literal game playing and conveying information totally miss you over your head every single time? But it gets worse. It gets worse.
Okay.
Okay. Is charging always this noise?
I don't understand what... I'm just trying to listen to the dialogue, man. Like, is that... That's what they want you to do? They want you to be trying to listen to the dialogue about what just happened, and then I've got to run away from some invisible thing that can kill me? Like, come on, bro. Don't do this. That's just stalker. That's how it's supposed to be. That's freaking dumb. That's poorly designed. I'm just trying to listen to the dialogue. I'm like, oh, what's going to happen is dead. There were anomalies on the ground. It literally told me to go do that, so I did it, and then they were talking, so I was listening to them talk.
No. No. We're not doing this, logician. We're not doing this. You literally sat there, and you were told, hey, do not stand in the field of the actual charging station when it goes off. There's radiation. You had to go and get an actual artifact to reduce radiation damage as you were playing the game. You then had to defeat the Bloodsucker to then get to that actual spot to put down the charger. What you did was you sat in the radiated field. You sat in it as it went off. Did nothing to move. We're looking at the ground like, oh, look, those same exact electrical sparks that I saw earlier that killed me, they're all over the place now too. I should be careful. No, you didn't do any of that. You sat and you listened to the entire conversation, and then you wondered why you died. You wondered why you died. If you wanted to sit there and you were talking about, I wanted to listen to what they were saying, you would have heard from earlier when they said, when you put this sumbitch down, run away because you need to not be in the field when it goes off. So clearly, you weren't paying attention when that happened. Then you did the exact same thing they told you not to do, and now you're like, ugh, this game doesn't want me to have fun. No! It's not supposed to be fun! This is a military sim horror game that's set in Eastern Europe! It's not supposed to be fun. It's oppressive. That's the whole point of it. You're supposed to be engrossed and scared and being like, I should take my time and be cautious about things. You were literally told that in the very beginning of the game and you still refuse to do it. This is not Call of Duty. But yet it continues. Oh, yes, ladies and gentlemen. It continues.
Bolts can help you discover an anomaly, determine its boundaries, and even temporarily neutralize it with left bumper to open up the radio menu and select a bolt. Okay. This is one of those games where they make it so hard to enjoy it. It's like they don't want you to enjoy the game. It's like...
I can't. This is the most simple, basic concept to grasp and understand. The NPC literally gave you the bolt and he said, throw it into the anomaly. You threw it into the one in the center, realizing there are three of them in front of you. Hell, before that, you threw it into the one in front of you where you're like, oh, this little thing gusted up and I can just make them go through. On top of that, before that, in the actual cutscene, you kicked a dog into the anomaly and it exploded into red mist. So it's telling you, the game is literally telling you, these things are dangerous. Do not walk into them. So what do with your big brain logician-sized head? You walk into the anomaly, you throw the bolt into the middle one, you wait for it to reset, then walk into it as it's returning, and then you get pulled into the other one because it pushed you into that one. And then you're like, oh, they don't want you to have fun. It's not God of War. There's no kid next to you telling you, hey, you should do this thing. Did you put the puzzle pieces with the same image together? That way to open the door? You got a big brain, Mr. 40 IQ. You're so smart at playing video games. This is a game from 2007. We can clearly tell you never played video games before this entire generation. Because clearly, if you did, you would be like, oh, I know exactly what to do here, because every game since the 80s had contextual information telling you this is how you do the thing. And you realized, oh, that is bad. How did you get through Elden Ring? How did you get through any Souls game? How did you play any video game that wasn't a current AAA modern slot-filled garbage? This is insane. And you know what, ladies and gentlemen? When I said he is our DSP, I really wasn't kidding. Take a look.
Okay. Huh? Hold on, I'm making sure you're not an anomaly. Huh? Yeah, I'm not convinced yet. A few dozen more of these. Huh? Yeah. I know they bounce right off the head, bonk. Like I'm made of rubber. Bonk. Come on. Stand still so I can hit you with this. Stop moving. Dude, he's literally dodging on purpose. Here. Huh. Can I put one up his nose?
Like two peas in a pod. They're the same person. Literally, they're the exact same person. I can't even comprehend the fact that both of them did the exact same thing in the exact same part, in the exact same section, and then they both got angry that it happened. Our God is an awesome God. Bro, literally, there can't be any more evidence right now. You are our DSP. I cannot wait for PlayStation developers to use you as a means of how to develop video games. Because clearly, if anybody plays games like you, this hobby is f***ed. It is totally f***ed beyond every sense of the word.
This game coming to PlayStation? It will eventually, yes. And the sad reality is, by then, they'll have patched a lot of the issues. If they tap into PS5 Pro enhancements, it'll likely run better. You know what I mean? It might have won Game of the Year in 2015. I don't know. I think the previews were, I don't know what. I don't know what they played in the dadgum previews, but I remember Luke Stevens saying when he played the game, it didn't perform great, mechanics were not explained well, and you died a lot. I literally just had that experience for 50 minutes. And everybody bashed on him and gave him hate, but it's like, I feel like he kind of described what I just engaged with. I don't know what to tell you.
Imagine not understanding what Stalker actually is, pretending it's Call of Duty, and then being like, oh, well, Luke Stevens also said this, and he got flamed for it because he didn't understand Stalker. This is not Fallout. This is not Call of Duty. This is not a action game that you play. This is a horror game military sim. You ever heard of Tarkov? This is what Tarkov got its idea from. That's what this is. This is an oppressive, grindy, ridiculously difficult, horror-infested kind of game where everything is suspenseful and tense, and the atmosphere is cranked up to 11. It's beautiful in every sense of the word. That's why I knew it wasn't going to review well, because game reviewers are just like you. They only want the simple, hold my hand, walk me through it, third-person, cover-based action-adventure game with stealth elements, gameplay. Press X to win, cutscene time, put the controller down. Boy, I sure love video games. That is what you are pushing. That is what you've always wanted to be. And the thing is, my boy, that's not gaming. That's not a video game. Stalker 2 is a literal video game. You're talking about wanting to play Path of Exile 2, by the way. You're not making it past Act 1. I guarantee it, you're not making it past Act 1. There's no fucking shot you're gonna make it. Oh, I can't. It's gonna be more accessible. Boy, honey, you got a big storm coming. And we see this every single time, ladies and gentlemen. The goalpost gets shifted over and over again. If it's not, oh, Game Pass cannibalizes sales, it's, oh, well, how many sales did it make on Xbox and not PC? It's the same shit every time. Oh, it's gonna sell more on PlayStation, but then you got it on Game. Who gives a shit? Like you guys are sitting here talking about sales of a console and a plastic box and video games instead of actually playing the video games. Why? Just play the games instead of talking about how many sales happen. But you know what? You won't do it. Because the second you try to actually play a video game, you get fucking filtered. And it happens every single time. You gotta love it. So ladies and gentlemen, if you liked today's video, thank you. And if you didn't like it, fuck you. If you want to see more of this kind of content, more PC port reviews, gaming news, Steam Deck videos, fanboy content like this, hot takes from me, and live streams every Saturday night, 8:45 p.m. Eastern, subscribe to the channel. We're on our way to 76K. And I just want to say thank you very much. If you want Discord access or emotes during live streams, become a YouTube member. It's as low as a dollar. If you don't want to spend the buck, don't sweat it. Hang out Saturday nights, 8:45 p.m. Eastern, on this channel for a live stream. Trust me, you're going to love it. It's actually insane. But with all that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one. And I'll see you tonight, 8:45. It's time to stop.
Stop. Just stop.